how a rocket works. Imagine if you have a balloon by the nozzle and you let it go and the air comes out. Congratulations, you are now Neil's strong arm. Well, kind of. You see, for something to be a rocket, it needs jet propulsion, which is just gases getting squeezed together and then thrown out really fast. That's actually why farting in space pushes you. Let's see if this works.
Hey, if you use hot gas, it will push you more than cold gas.
Oh yeah, that's because hot gas is moving around more. So let's just spark it and set it on fire. Cool, our rocket takes off. Oh yeah, fire's disabled in space. It's right here in the Outer Space Treaty. Wait, but why doesn't it work?
Cause fire needs three things to work.
Oh yeah, I knew that. Fires need a spark, fuel, and oxygen. Okay, we got the fuel and the spark. Bro, forgot the oxygen!
Oh my God!
But what if we do our own oxygen?
That is the dumbest idea I've ever heard. Okay, but hear me out. We just need the fire to think it's on Earth, right? So what if we put an oxygen layer around the fire? So we'll release some oxygen, then the flammable gas, then ignite it. Okay, and just use any flammable gas. It doesn't matter which one you use. Here's what the famous companies use. You can store both gases as a liquid and then convert when needed. Storing both the fuel and oxidizer tanks is what most of the weight and space in the rocket is used for.
Wait, shape. What shape should a rocket be?
Well, you can do any shape you want, but some shapes cut through the air better than others. This is called being aerodynamic. Now let's play a game. Will this cut through the air? First, we have a knife shape.
Yeah, I reckon it'll be aerodynamic. I use these to cut through my sister's cakes.
That is wrong. There is no space to put the two tanks. Remember, if you fail, I will cut through you.
What?
Next, we have a cone shape.
No, like it's so fat. Of course it's not aerodynamic. What am I, a clown?
That's 2 for 2. This is actually one of the most aerodynamic shapes, actually. Okay, last question. What about this shape?
What? I can't even see it.
That's right, it's Jeff Bezos' little rocket, and we had to blur it because of its weird shape.
No!
Yeah, so making the shape pointy means less air is pushing against you.
What?
Hey, you can't just go fast and expect us to move out of the way. We will stand in your way and push you back.
Everyone push back!
Sir, it seems there's nothing for us to push against. It's too slippery.
Basically that, but faster. Aerodynamics increase speed, but you know what's the biggest factor limiting our speed?
I'll go with option B, clouds.
No, it's actually humans! We could go much faster, but we have to make sure our little brain monkeys don't get a little boo-boo. Bruh, they be doing this when they get to space.
Number 2, right here. And then you can swallow it.
But the pointy shape only matters when it's on a planet. In space, you can have any shape you want without worrying about the aerodynamics. Cause there's literally nothing to push back against you. Well, kind of. That's why you can have stuff like this that goes 11 miles.
Per second.
Oh, and speaking of aeronautic engineering, you put all the heavy stuff at the top as it helps balance the rocket. Okay, the rocket's done. Just put some crap at the top to balance things out.
Sir, what if we put cargo or a satellite or animals up there?
You're a genius, kid. Say, what's your name?
It's Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Okay, so everything's set. Let's send it up and see what happens.
Oh my days, it died!
Okay, it seems that even the slightest bit of wind will push it sideways. How would I fix this? The guidance, navigation, and control system tells the rocket its height, speed, and direction, and other stuff. So the rocket can rotate the nozzles and stay upright. And once you reach space, you can just disconnect the extra fuel tanks and throw them in the ocean for the fish to use. I'm serious, don't try to save money by reusing these. I mean, theoretically, how would you even use them again? You'd have to save some fuel and then use that to land and whatever. It's impossible, bro. You can't do it. Speaking of launching, how to launch? Well, you can just go straight up if you want it, but you can also get an extra boost if you do it from the equator. Cause like, Earth's rotation helps like, get you into space.
But what if we need to go really fast? Like, out of the solar system?
Shut up!
Okay, yeah, you can use other planets to do that. This is when you go around a planet over and over again, building up speed and then slingshotting out into whatever direction you want. This process is called a flyby, and it has absolutely zero side effects. But rockets are changing. For example, spin launch literally spins the craft really, really fast and then just randomly lets go and it launches into the stratosphere.
Okay, that's the video. I don't know how to end it. Bye.